Hello kid, today we are going to learn the importance of shelter. Well, where do you find your shelter? Obviously, your home, sweet home, correct? So let's see an instance of it. Today we are going to meet Harpreet. She is a kid just like you. Well, how do you feel in the last period of your school? Amazingly excited. Why is that? Because once that's over, you can rush out of the school and go back home. Correct? Similarly, that day, Harpreet was super happy. She looked outside through the window and saw that there were dark clouds all across. And finally, she thought, once it's over, she will walk back home. So let's see what happened next. Well, when Harpreet came out of her school, she saw the sky was really, really filled with dark clouds and it was going to be a heavy downpour. But still, Harpreet thought to explore the nature and she started walking. So, as she was walking, suddenly there was a big thunderous sound and lightning. Poor Harpreet, she got scared all of a sudden and she started running back home. And while doing so, the rain started all over. And finally, Harpreet could feel the big droplets of rainfall coming and hitting her badly. Poor Harpreet, she didn't even have a raincoat to cover herself. So what to do now? She had to run back in that rainfall only. Well, after some time, she found out a tea stall and took a shelter just underneath the asbestos roof. But that was not at all enough. She was still getting wet because there was a thunderous storm going on. But luckily, after some time, it got subsided and Harpreet could walk back home. So when Harpreet came back home, she thought, when I am at home, neither the thunderous rain nor the burning sun can touch me. So, home is the best shelter that one can have. So, on reaching home, Harpreet's mother took a dry towel and started wiping off her wet hair. And finally, she told her to change her wet uniform as well. Well, after changing the uniform and having food, Harpreet thought to lie down. And she understood how important was the ceiling, the walls of her houses, because the house was protecting her and her family from the extreme weather conditions. And moreover, it is very much comfortable as well after a hard, tiring day. Correct? So, I have a question for you. What is the importance of home? It has TV and AC, or there are pastries and cold drinks in the refrigerator, or it provides comfort. Which one do you think is the correct option? Well, is our home the sweetest place just because it has got the TV and the AC? Can't we live without these things? Yes, of course, I understand that TV allows you to watch wonderful cartoons. And even during the summer, the AC gives you cool breeze. Even in the refrigerator, you get pastries, cold drinks, all the good food that you can imagine for. But other than these two, home also provides comfort and it provides shelter and safety. So, home is the sweetest place for all of us. Now, Harpreet with her family went to a village in Assam. And there she found the houses were very different from hers. Well, she found the houses were made of bamboos. They stood on bamboo poles and had sloping roofs. She got confused. Why is this house made up of bamboos? Why do they have sloping roofs? Her house doesn't have like this. Well, the local boy said these kind of houses are known as the stilt houses, because in these kind of places wherein they experience a lot of rainfall, floods occur, and due to which the water enters into the normal houses. So that's why they use the bamboos and they built the houses on the bamboo poles, so that the house is elevated from the ground and the flood water cannot enter the house. Now, what about the sloping roofs? Well, since there is a lot of rainfall, the sloping roof helps it sliding down the water, and the water doesn't enter the house. So in this way, the stilt houses are made in places where there is a very heavy rainfall and bamboos are the only building material that is available. Hearing that, Harpreet got super excited. She asked her mom, what are the different houses that are available all across the world? So her mother told her there are houses named as the igloo, the house on wheels, the apartments, the houseboats, house with sloping roof, tent, and the stilt houses. So let's go to the land of Arctic. Well, we all know that place is covered with snow, correct? So what kind of house do you see here? A round shaped house made of snow. And what is that called? It is called an igloo. Well, the igloo is made of ice blocks which is cut from ice sheets, and then they are stacked in such a way that they form a dome shaped structure. Over here we can see the place is covered with snow, even the house is made from snow. Well, don't you think this person will feel cold inside the house? Not at all. Why is that? Because the air trapped inside the ice blocks keep it warm by preventing the heat from going outside. So people in the Arctic region always stays in igloos. Now, coming to the deserts of Africa and India. Well, what do we see here? Do we find an igloo over here as well? Not really. Here we see there is a tent. Well, this is a roof-like structure that has been formed with thick cloth, because in deserts there are lot of sandstorms. So always the people in the desert use tents. There is one more thing over here. What is that? In deserts, the people keep on moving in search of food and water. So they need a home that they can carry with themselves. Whenever they want to stay in a particular place, they put up the tent, stay over there, and when they want to move away, they can wrap the cloth and take it along with them. So that's why a tent is always used as a home in deserts. Now, do you know that there are houses which keep on moving on the wheels? Well, sounds unfamiliar, correct? But this is absolutely correct. There are traders who buy and sell goods and keep on traveling, but they need a home to stay as well, right? So they get all the basic amenities in this home-like structure, and they are on the wheels. That's why the name is house on wheels. So this is a home for the traders who keep on traveling. Now, coming to Kerala, the backwaters. Well, doesn't this look beautiful? Of course it is. What is this? Is it a normal boat? Not at all. This house-like structure in the boat is used for staying. So this is known as a houseboat. But other than staying, there are other facilities as well. If you see here, this is a beautiful houseboat, correct? Which is used for staying, for tourists as well. So they are used as hotels. Well, Wouldn't you like to be in one of these hotels as well? Sounds very interesting, correct? So not only for staying, they also move around on the water and helps in sightseeing. Over here, Harpreet remembered that when they had gone to Kashmir last year, they had seen houseboat over there as well. So not only in Kerala, in Kashmir as well, you find houseboats as floating hotels. Now this is Harpreet's flat over here, but this is the structure which you would find in cities and other places as well. What are these structures? They are known as buildings. This is a tall structure with number of stories in it, and each story has around 3 to 4 flats which are of identical design. Let's see how Harpreet's flat looks. Well, over here first you enter and you find the living room. Once you are coming this way, you find the kitchen and the balcony, and when you are getting inside, you find 2 bedrooms, 2 washrooms and another balcony over here itself. Well, do you find any resemblance with your home as well? Correct. So, why do we need the building over here? Why don't we stay in igloo or tent or house on wheels in cities? Because in cities, there are lots of people who are staying. And if we want to give them a space to stay, we need to construct the buildings wherein many people can stay in the same floor, and there are parking space as well for the people staying over there. So, I have a question for you. Why are houses made in different ways? Is it because people love making different types of houses? Or is it because people make houses according to their needs? Can you tell me the correct answer? Well, the correct answer is, people make houses according to their needs. And not only this, it depends on many factors like the place where you are staying, the geographical area, the building materials that are present in abundance and readily available. All those things are taken into consideration when you're building a house over there. So, I'm sure, my dear kid, you're all excited to know the different kind of houses that people live in all across the world. And these houses provide shelter to all of us.